something, Jane. I was going to wear a catcher's mask. Still, things are going well. I've got a great family. We're going to bottle them. Called Mullen Power. Yeah! City's finest, they got to be proud of you. How much did you win when you became the champ?
Well, we won a little over $5,500, Richard.
Well, say it exactly.
We won $5,585.
Yeah! The reason I get you to say it exactly is you just say 55. Phil down there takes the 85,000, puts it away. He's about to retire in about a week
good
and
answer,
a half.
Good answer.
Let me meet everybody here, please.
Okay, Richard, this is Tom, my brother.
Hi, Richard.
Twin brother.
Twin brother. Very handsome. My brother David.
David.
Richard.
Nice to have you.
My brother Rob.
Richard.
Rob.
And my brother John.
Hi, Richard.
A nice big welcome. Yeah. Now, you gave me that marvelous football from Brigham Young University, signed by all the players. I want to know now, do you know the new Miss America?
Well, I have met the new Miss America, and...
What? Tell me her name.
Her name is Charlene Wells.
And you have met her?
She's from BYU.
Oh, really? Anybody else know her?
She's the Miss BYU, as a matter of fact. She holds the Miss BYU title also.
Yeah?
But all
do you all know her?
Met her.
Just met her.
Yes, but
the two single ones are going over after this to meet her.
That's right. Now
are
I have
you
enough
married?
Money to take her out. Not
no,
me, he's not.
No, I'm married to my wife.
I know you're married to your wife. I just wanted to know if anybody had ever gone out socially with her. I think she's lovely. But
Steve Young did once.
Well, he's a quarterback.
That's right.
But see, now we've won a
family. If I were a quarterback,
too.
I could go out with anybody. My luck, I'll go out with Vince Ferragamo.
Better
go
out with
my
brother.
Make a pass, and I'll drop it. Brothers, right out. What a luck, please. These are killers.
Oh, I know. We got them. We're getting stopped.
Really? Let me meet everybody, please.
All right.
Who you got here?
This is my lovely wife, Chris.
Hi, Richard.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And this is her brother, David.
David.
Hello, Richard.
And his wife, Amber.
Hi.
Hello, my husband.
And this is our mother-in-law, Eleanor. My mother-in-law.
Richard, in our family, we are all chocoholics. And these are hot lips, specially made for Richard.
Yeah.
Send a message downstairs to Brian. Get the suits let out about 3 inches. Play the feud. Let's go. Good luck, man. 100 people survey. Top 6 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something besides taking a pill that helps you get to sleep. David.
A drink of water.
A drink of water. No.
Reading.
Really? Very good.
Richard, we would like to play.
Well, you got it. Perfect.
Okay.
So nice to see you, young man.
Good to see you, Richard.
Besides a pill now, what would help you get to sleep?
Well, when Family Feud isn't on, TV helps me get to sleep.
Oh, good
TV? Nothing. I swear to you, I've done it, and I know more people that go to sleep with television on. That's, of course, our programming, but it's not our fault.
Richard.
You doing, sir? What's going to help us get to sleep besides a pill?
Listening to mellow music.
Mellow music?
Yeah.
Rob, what is it, sir?
I count sheep.
Well, do you?
Oh, well, sometimes.
Count sheep. Drives me crazy. How are you?
But again.
Get a lollipop.
Come on, John.
Oh!
Because that's the last time and became a chance. What do you say?
I would say a glass of warm milk.
Yeah.
Warm milk.
What is it, John?
Well, not being a married man, but from what I've heard, consortium. Well, that's a legal term for making love.
Thank you.
I don't know.
Don't take all the fun out of it by being legal. Making love.
Come. Okay, Tom.
All Mormons give disclaimers when they get out.
That's right.
All right, what do you say? It's true.
say talking to someone.
All right. Because there you got it. Talk to someone? No, not there. David to the rescue, sir.
Nice warm bath.
Yeah!
Nice warm bath for the money.
Oh! Good try.
$81 up there. And David. There, you get it. If not, give it to Don, a little wine.
All right.
You got it. But to take a warm bath is an excellent, really. I can never finish it. It's too much for me, but we'll be back right after this.
Powerful solid Aloisin scent.
Clean and fresh.
Some computers are complicated and tough to understand, but other computers are a lot of fun, and they make learning very easy, like the Tomy Tutor Play Computer. It's a toy computer that actually has moving pictures, and it can teach your children about colors, letters, numbers, and even how to spell. The Tomy Tutor Play Computer may never solve any of the world's problems. Then again, maybe it will. The Tutor Play Computer by Tomy.
The Perfect BLT by Best Foods.
If there's one thing I know how to build, it's a BLT with fresh iceberg lettuce, big beefsteak tomatoes. That's key. Bacon from Leo the Butcher. Now, if you think I'm going to put some bargain mayonnaise on this, you haven't tasted Best Foods. Best Foods taste fresher. Ask anybody. Ask your mom. Mom.
Bring out the best foods and bring out the best.
All right, 81, play 67. Let's go.
David.
Like bookends here, David, David, and David, part three. 100 people survey, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that makes a house smell great. David.
Deodorizer.
Deodorizer.
Oh, yeah, good answer, David.
Two answers will be that, David.
Home cooking.
Home cooking.
Right there.
Something you do to make someone smile.
Give them flowers.
Give them flowers.
Oh.
I say give them a smile first.
Smile first. What a cowgirl it would be, huh?
How about showing a little affection?
Oh, good answer.
Okay, Don. Little affection? No. That's right, David.
Compliment them.
Uh-huh. Give them a compliment. You're the best stilt walker I've ever seen. Thank you.
Give them a present.
Oh, yeah.
We had flowers. That would be a present, wouldn't it? Yeah. All presents have been given.
All presents have been given. Take them out to dinner.
Good answer.
Make Dom DeLuise smile. Take them out to dinner?
Mm.
No. $78 there. Come along, David.
Your
unrevealed answer. Name something you do to make someone smile.
Richard, give him a kiss.
Give him a kiss.
All right. Good answer. Good answer.
I would have gone. Used to do work in my day. Little kiss gets you the money. If not, my buddies get it. Kiss. $173 to $145. Let's go. Come on. Dollar values have doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that you would wear even if it had a hole in it.
Pants.
Two answers will beat it, Elliot.
A dress.
Not there. Player pass.
Play.
Okay. Eleanor does. It's all right, Eleanor. They're going to play anyway.
I still wear my shirt if it had a hole in it.
You're not wearing it today, eh? Oh, how disgusting. Shirt? No. He doesn't have a hole in it.
How about your socks?
Yeah.
Socks?
You know that's going to be number one, David. Something you'd wear even if it had a hole in it.
Underwear.
Nice people.
here, and what do you get? A wet, misty spray. That's why Renew the invented Fresh and Dry. It's really dry. No wet mist or powder in the air or anywhere. Spray Fresh and Dry anywhere. It's so dry, it freshens the air, your carpet, your upholstery, without wetness. Why spray wet? Spray Fresh and Dry from Renew It.
It's dry.
The only air freshener you can spray anywhere.
Men's sportswear, men's dresswear, men. With everything from cotton to cashmere, if you care, you'll bother. Don't wear one without the other.
BAM Roll-On. It's like an invisible layer of protection against wetness between you and your clothes. No leading spray can keep you as dry.
If you care, you'll bother. Don't wear one without the other.
BAM Roll-On. You and your clothes can depend on it.
Tyson chicken chunks. Golden. Crispy. Quick and easy, too. Next time the kids say,
Mom, I'm late for... Wow, chicken chunks. Super.
100% chicken. John loves chicken. Perfect when he wants it.
Delicious, hon. Gotta go.
And just 250 calories a serving.
At Tyson, we're doing our best.
Golden, crispy Tyson chicken chunks.
Just for you.
A new hot cereal made with delicious sun-made fruits?
New sun-made instant hot cereal. Made great that sun-made way. Sun-made, warm and delicious.
Sun-made, you made my day.
Sun-made instant hot cereal. Sun-made fruits that taste so great. Wholesome, highly sweet and flavorful.
Sun-made, you made my day.
If you like sun-made fruits a lot, you're going to love new sun-made hot.
Sun-made, you made my day.
15 seconds, please. Name the month when you first turn on the heat in your home.
October.
The hour when bars open.
6 o'clock.
Something in the sky that people stare at.
Stars.
The busiest day of the week.
Monday.
A color of a parakeet.
Yellow.
All right. When you said the bars open, is that a.m. or p.m.? You have to give me.
P.M.
All right.
I don't drink.
Oh, I know that.
I don't know when they open.
But they want to know a.m. or p.m. Shoot. Month when you first turn on the heat in your home, you said October. Survey said?
Yeah!
Hour when bars open, you said 6 p.m. Survey said?
Oh!
All right.
Something in the sky that people stare at. Stars. Survey.
Yeah!
Busiest day of the week. What did you say, Monday?
Monday.
Survey said.
Yeah!
Color of a parakeet, you said. Yellow, survey said.
All right!
Here comes Tom.
Right, Tom.
53 points for all you need. You wish you luck. 53 points gets you another $5,000. Please remind everyone the answers John gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck now.
Thanks.
Name the month when you first turn on the heat in your home.
November.
The hour when bars open.
10 o'clock.
Something in the sky that people stare at.
Rainbows.
The busiest day of the week.
Saturday.
A color of a parakeet.
Yellow.
Brown. What? A.M. or P.M. when the bars open?
A.M.
A.M. The month you first turn on the heat in your home, October was number one. You said November. Survey said?
Yeah!
Well, hour when bars open, number one answer was 11 a.m. Well, I knew that you know. You said 10 a.m. and got 3 votes from our audience right here. You need 16 points for the money. Survey said? Something in the sky that people stare at. Stars, number one. You said a rainbow. 3 points. $5,000 more. Survey said? At the end of the rainbow was a busiest day of the week. You said Saturday. Friday was the number one answer. Saturday's worth 3 points. You got it? Survey said... All right, for both of you. 100 people survey. Top 7 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something both men and women carry with them at all times.
Driver's license.
Driver's license.
Answer. Right.
One answer will beat it, Tom.
Money.
Money. Got it by 2 points. That's good.
We're going to play, Richard.
All right.
How about a wallet?
All right, let's see.
A wallet?
Well done, well done. David.
Richard.
What do you think, sir?
Keys.
Oh, good answer.
Another good answer, keys. Yes,
sir.
Just rolling along here. Rob.
Richard. I'd say a comb.
Good answer.
Hey, comb. How are you, champ?
Just fine.
Take a look.
Ooh, come on, JJ.
Come on.
Oh!
Good luck.
What do men and women carry with them at all times?
A wedding ring.
Okay, let's see.
Oh, good answer.
Wedding ring.
No.
What a good answer.
It was not just a good answer. It was a nice answer. I liked it, but it wasn't
nice
up there.
Nice answer.
Shut up. What do you think?
Gonna go with a credit card.
Oh,
yeah.
Credit card.
Oh.
Ooh. Yeah, like a winner. What is it?
I see something to write with.
Okay.
Oh, good job.
Do you need the implement at all? A writing implement?
Oh.
Not that. $88. Come on, Tom.
All right.
A watch.
Handkerchief.
Time piece. Oh,
minimum carry at all time. What?
Richard, watch.
Watch gets you $88. If not, down on the boys' gift. Tick tock a watch. Looks like I get all the wind. That's a great answer you gave me, but it's not there. But amazing. Does that not sound like a winning answer?
Great answer.
Of course, it's a great answer for you. Four.
ID
card. And 7. Still thought a watch was good. Jose Greco's birthday. We'll be back right now.
Hey, Max, what's going on, huh?
I'm stocking up on Meaty Bone dog biscuits.
Meaty Bone?
Any good?
You kidding?
Meaty Bones are great.
Come on.
Look, Meaty Bone's crunchy, like ordinary biscuits.
Oh?
But Meaty Bone bakes on a rich, meaty sauce my customers love.
Hey, these even taste better than Milk Bones.
Sure.
You know your meat, Max.
Oh, what do I look like, a carpenter?
Meaty Bone dog biscuits. The meaty taste tastes better.
Hey, Max, how'd you like a partner?
Oh, sure. And watch you eat all the profits.
See this ugly yellow stain? That's what comes from cigar or cigarette smoke. Just think what smoking a pack a day, every day, could do to your teeth. But look, here's Topol, the smoker's tooth polish that helps remove all kinds of superficial tobacco stains. Topol starts to work immediately to clean your teeth and to help remove these stains. Just use Topol week after week and watch your teeth get brighter and brighter. Topol, the smoker's tooth polish, available in regular, fluoride, and gel.
But Champ's got the money, 88. Nothing here yet. Come on, let's go. How you doing? 100 people survey. Top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a way in which some people like to end the day. Tom.
Have a drink. Richard, we'll play.
I think some people like to end the day, David.
Sleeping.
Oh, yeah. Good answer.
Yeah.
Nice answer.
Sleeping.
Oh, yeah.
Buy something to eat. Get something to eat.
Yeah.
Eat.
Oh.
Well, that's good. You'll know a lot of people are not running out buying pizzas. Tom.
How about make love?
Good answer.
If fact that I live alone is going to cramp my style a little, but make love! To end the day, what do you think?
I'm going to say they're going to read.
Ooh, good answer.
You often say that that's a good answer. And you like to read?
Read.
I love to read. I'm reading How to Make Love and Drink Alcohol in Bed at the Same Time. Great!
Good job. I'm going to say take a bath.
Yeah. fine for Fredness, doesn't
it? Yes, Richard.
Congratulations. Well done. Be easy for him. Be an official. Give lollipops to kids. You can recognize a $100 one miles away. What a high wire performer you use tonight.
A net.
A net, if they're wide. Yeah. Tom?
Well, something I think they'd need, or they wouldn't be up there very long, a balancing rod.
A balancing rod. You got it.
A shoe without a slippery surface.
Yeah. They do. They've got special shoes. That's a special shoe. Not there.
A ball?
Ball? Okay. A ball? No. Well, they use those, it just didn't make it. No.
How about a wire?
I think it's essential, don't you?
Absolutely.
Otherwise, you stay in the net all the time.
That's right.
Hey, John, I've got to be there. A wire! Of course! Burton! One more left, sir. What is it? Don't you hate it when the doctor keeps you waiting?
Yes. No appointment for this. How's about some ankle, wrist covers, wrist and ankle covers?
Certainly not a scientific answer. I will take a look there. The old wrist and ankle covers. Now, $92. Do they have to be correct together?
Music, chair.
We'll go with chair.
What about musical chairs? All right.
We'll go with chair.
Chair, you get the 92. If not, we'll give it to Tom. A chair!
Yeah!
180. Plays 82. Come on, let's go. People survey, top five answers on the board. Here is the question. Name something people buy for a horse.
Yes. Saddle.
Saddle.
Mister, we like to play.
That's all I seem to be saying to your family. They're going to play.
All right.
What do people buy for a horse?
A halter.
Halter. A halter, please. Yeah. A horse, what would you buy for?
Well, I would buy him food.
Food.
Good answer.
Food.
All right.
You buy your horse what?
I'm going to say, so he doesn't hurt his little feet, shoes.
That's right. Shoes? They come with shoes. David.
A horse blanket.
Yeah.
Horse blanket made out of a real horse.
They like to have their little hairs brushed, so I'd say a brush.
You're telling me a little more about horses than I wish to know. A brush!
Oh!
Big John, what is it?
How about a stable?
Okay. If it's there, you got it. Stable!
Oh!
There. Again, we've got a chance to get this number five is under review. Something to buy for a horse. Now, we've already had all the harness and rein saddle.
That's all in one.
Give me another one.
How about the blinders up above the eyes?
Not the same. All right.
We'll use that then.
Okay, I'll put that for you. Blinders get you the $96. If not, give it to Tom. Blinders! $276 to $82. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people eat with cheese. Yeah.
Bread.
Your chance, Doc. Three answers will beat it.
Crackers?
You get it. Doc, come back here, please.
Good answer.
You left without an appointment. Now, are you going to play or pass?
We'll play.
Just to get control of the question from these boys, because they're great players. I'm proud of you. Now, let's make it pay off. Something people... people eat with cheese.
How about shrimp, Richard?
Shrimp? Oh, it's a dying krillman in the shell.
Fruit.
Yeah, do you need a particular one? Little fruit with the cheese, eh? Fromaggio. No!
Wine?
You need the cheese, a little wine?
I don't know.
Oh. Okay,
go,
okay,
go,
okay, go, okay, go, okay,
pizza,
okay,
pizza, 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 pizza,
pizza,
pizza,
pizza,
pizza,
pizza.
We're gonna go pizza.
We love pizza with cheese.
Hey, pizza enough for a win? If not, give it to Tom. Pizza? Once before you forgot the great American apple pie, you mentioned it this time and didn't. That must be there. Two. And three. Five.
Five.
Now look at this. 260, 276. It's all down to this. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a busy holiday for candy stores.
Yep. Easter.
Easter? What answer will beat it?
I'm going to go Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day? You're playing a great day.
We're going to play, Richard.
All right.
I'm
going to
go over here.
Okay, Tom. I'll read it once. I can't repeat it. 3 seconds to answer when I get to you. Name a busy holiday for candy stores.
Christmas.
Christmas? Ho, ho, ho.
Yeah!
2 seconds, David.
Halloween!
If it's there, you keep the title, Halloween Part 3.
Yeah!
Little boys like, but little girls don't. late age to get married.
28.
The kind of business with neon signs.
Restaurant.
Dessert made with fruit.
Apple pie.
The length of the average movie.
2 hours.
2 hours, he started it. Something little boy likes, little girls don't. Trucks. That is it. Late age to get married. 28. Survey. You and your weird years. Kind of business from the unsigned. You said. Restaurant. Survey said. Yeah. Good thing it's fruit. You said. Fine. Survey said.
Yeah.
What's the average movie? 2 hours. Survey said.
Yeah.
Okay. Got another $5,000. Please remind everyone the answers John gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something little boys like that little girls don't.
Snakes.
A late age to get married.
30.
Kind of business with neon signs.
Pizza.
Try again.
Hamburgers.
No more food. Try again.
Discotheque.
Dessert made with fruit.
Apple pie.
Try again.
Ice cream.
The length of the average movie.
2 hours.
Try again.
Hour and a half.
Turn around. Yeah. Little boys like, little girls don't. The number one answer, frogs and toads. You said snakes. Survey said. Yeah. Late age to get married. You said 30. We need 37 points for $5,000. Survey said. Restaurant, number one, you said disco. 8 points we need. Survey said. Two. Dessert made with fruit. Pie was number one. You said ice cream. 6 points we need. Survey said. Length of the average movie. 2 hours was number one. You said hour and a half. If it's not worth 1 point, I'm going to leave the movie. Survey said.
Sugar. My kids eat too much sugar. I'm in the same boat.
Well, if less sugar is what you want, just switch from your peanut butter to nutritious Skippy.
Oh, Annette, there's no difference in peanut butters.
Sure is. No peanut butter is better for kids than nutritious Skippy. And of all the leading national brands, only Creamy Skippy has half the added sugars.
Half the added sugars? That's great.
Tastes great, too, Mom.
Yeah.
For good nutrition, no peanut butter's better.
Then Skippy.
Right, Skipper.
Hey, have you got the biggest news in frying? Wesson's bottle is lighter than ever. Pass it on. Wesson does feel lighter. This new plastic bottle's easier to handle. It's got a built-in no-dip top. And no more mess.
Wesson's new light plastic bottle is shatterproof, too.
What's best about Wesson is the way it fries. Light, crispy, and juicy. Pick up Wesson in the new plastic bottle. It's lighter than ever. And pass it on.
I'm Peter Jennings. On ABC's World News tonight, a puzzling health phenomenon in Puerto Rico. Thousands of girls and boys are experiencing abnormally early sexual development. It may have something to do with the food they eat.
But thank you anyway, Jane. We love you. We'll see you on the blue.
Some departing contestants receive the Windmere Pro 1500 Plus complete drying and styling system with special waving brush, curl dryer, and styling storage stand from Windmere Products. Uncle Ben's original long grain and wild rice for an original way to enhance any meal. Only Q-Tex Remover has moisture guard to protect nails against drying and breaking. No wonder it's America's number one remover. Tuna Helper has three delicious ways to turn plain tuna into a great meal, including Tuna Helper Tetrazzini. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson. Wesson, television production.
Tomorrow, Jack confesses his get-up-and-go for romance is gone on Freeze a Crowd. Then Angela learns the new man in her mom's life as a college kid on Who's the Boss. This is ABC.
Our family won a free trip to Hollywood and $10,000 on Family Feud.
Enter today. We want your family to be next. The KTVX Family Fortune tonight.
Leave the bother of daily lens care at home. Get extended wear soft contact lenses from the optical department at Sears. Sleep with them at night. Wake up to a bright, clear morning. Wear them all day, all night, up to 14 days. Extended wear soft contact lenses, only $129. And daily wear soft contact lenses are just $65 at the optical department at Sears.
Get a smooth for your
at the optical department.
At Sears.
I don't subscribe to cable TV, but if I did, I would decide which cable programs to watch, not the government. Cable TV has plenty of quality programming to choose from. But if Initiative A passes, the responsibility to choose what to watch won't be up to the individual. It'll be up to the government. Do we really want to restrict our individual freedom to make personal, private decisions in our own homes? Of course not. So keep cable TV an individual decision. Vote against Initiative A.
The Jeffersons today on...
Stay close and you're going to fall because there's a new step here that you're not used to. We're going to go down now. Ready? Step down now.
Go,
good,
go, go.
Got it. Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
And the Amrine family, on your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
An exciting day for us and a little sad day, too. It's one of our members who's been with us a long, long time. She's just absolutely delightful. We were thrilled because we sort of shared when she got married. Got married to a delightful young man, Pete Casey, who's a producer of The Jeffersons. Her name is Rosie. Where? Come here. I'm going to stand for her. Rosie Tony Casey. How are you? Now, Rosie is leaving us because she wants to write for a living, and she wants... You cannot write unless you write. You can't want to do it. You have to do it, right?
Right. Absolutely right.
Well, we're right about another thing. We love you. Mr. Kelly, if you come here, we...
Thank you very much.
I love you.
Richard, we just want you to know we think you are a nice guy. That was very nice of y'all to do that.
How much have you won?
Well, we've won just a little over $18,000. To be exact, $18,002. Come from a large family like we do?
You have to speak up.
You do. You starve to death at the dinner table.
Wishful thinking. Let me meet
it. Hey, Richard, this is my twin brother, Tom.
Hi, Richard.
My brother, David.
Hi, Richard.
My brother, Rob.
Hi, Richard.
And my brother, John.
Hi, Richard.
John. Woo! You know I love you.
Thanks, Richard.
Am I there? Give me a welcome. Now, you probably been watching them upstairs. You know they're steamrollers, so...
We're going to get them.
Good. That's the way to talk. Nice to meet everybody.
Richard,
great.
This is my daughter, Diane.
Hello, Richard.
Welcome, Diane.
My daughter,
thank
Susan.
Hi, Richard.
Susan. My daughter, Carol.
Hi, Richard.
And my daughter, Gail.
Hello, Richard.
And we didn't bring them all.
More?
Oh, I got a couple of more.
Better name them very quickly.
Jean and Nancy. And then number 7, which is why we were going all this way, was Jerry.
Now you're out of heaven. That's good. Now let's win some money. Let's play the feud. Let's go. $150 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something people save from their wedding.
I'm going to say a piece of cake.
Cake. I know he's he's not your brother. Give me a five. Five good bites.
How about the flea?
The flea?
Oh,
all
right.
May we see a flea, please?
Yeah.
People surveyed say earwig. They did not. Another chance. This time, two answers on the wheel.
A wasp.
Call it a wasp, Richard.
A wasp.
Oh, good answer. Yeah, good answer.
Wasp 91. If not big lead, one wasp. I mean, I know it was in the survey. What is the difference between a bank bug and a flea? I asked you first. We'll be back right after this.
Have you got heavy kitchen traffic? Well, there's one product that stands up to heavy traffic better than anything else. Mop and Glow. No matter what type of floor you have, Mop and Glow puts down a long-lasting shine that stands up to scrapes, scratches, even skid marks, better than any other floor care product. So, for a beautiful shine that stands up to heavy traffic, use Mop and Glow for a non-stop shine.
Hey, that's a nice toy.
It rolls.
Hmm.
What's that?
It's new. Mom got it.
It's big.
You get a lot.
You like it?
Yeah. Real soft. Pops up, too.
What does it do?
Keeps me clean.
Sounds good. What's it called?
Don't know. I can't read yet.
New Washer-by Baby Baby Wipes. They're baby soft. I'll trade you.
Green Giant Entrees. The taste of today.
No, crepes. The French make them.
You put in crepes? I'd say eggs.
Eggs.
Oh, good
No. All right, food that people put in crates.
Ham.
Ham, I like that. Yeah. Done.
Cheese.
Cheese.
Yeah. I just want to say one thing. David had a very lousy answer, and he was very lucky.
I'll second that.
I would like to say whipping cream.
Okay. Oh, whipped cream?
No.
That was a good answer. You got a strike. Exactly. What did you say?
Powdered sugar.
All right. We'll take a look. They're all right. If not, third strike. Powdered sugar.
Oh.
Two answers.
Let's get them. Come on.
Yeah, let's get them.
Shrimp. Okay. Seafood. Seafood. Mushroom.
Seafood.
If it's there, the 82's yours. I'm not even going to mention them this time. Seafood. Number six. Jam and jelly. 176 to 82. Let's go. Come on. I will wake up tonight and say cantaloupe. I swear to you, I thought he'd gone insane. Then he got the number one answer. 100 people survey, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a costume worn on Halloween.
Yeah. Skeleton.
Skeleton? Two answers will beat it.
Clown.
Clown?
Good job.
All right. What were you doing?
We went to play.
The costume worn on Halloween.
About a witch.
Oh. Yeah. A witch? Yeah. Huh?
The dreaded ghost.
The ghost.
A ghost.
Casper the ghost. Come.
I'd say a sports figure.
Which sort of sports?
Athletics, football.
If they want, you know, give us a costume. A guy doesn't go out with 19 pieces of equipment. Football player. One of the scariest costumes that I can think of. Thank you.
A fairy princess?
Oh,
what do you expect from a guy who gives you cantaloupe? Fairy princess?
Oh!
Stop!
How'd you dress as a famous person?
Whom?
Whom?
3 seconds.
Yoda.
You know who that is? All right. Okay. Yoda, Yoda.
Oh.
Okay, guys. One
answer. Monster. Monster. Vampire.
We'll go with a
monster,
Richard.
All right. Do you need a particular one? All right. What sort of monster?
A vampire.
A vampire. Vampire, you get it? If not, you do. Hello, vampire. Come on, let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you drink for reasons of...
Sorry.
Here's the question again. Name something you drink for reasons other than thirst. Yeah.
Alcohol.
Alcohol.
We're going to play, Richard.
Play it. Name something you drink for reasons other than thirst, Jared.
Medicine.
Medicine. Good answer. Medicine. What is it?
Hot chocolate, Richard.
Hot chocolate? No.
Orange juice and juices for health?
OJ! Yeah. Right. Not a good vitamin, Carol.
How about a health food shake with protein?
Uh-huh.
Protein shake.
All right. Protein health shake. Change our luck right now. Come on.
Yeah, let's go, baby.
Oh. But I have a good answer. Coffee.
Coffee. Yeah. Right now, Jerry, what is it?
Cheese.
Okay. 50's there. You got
it. Yeah, baby.
If not, third track tape. Chance right here. Keep the title if you're right.
Soft drink.
Well,
it's Coke.
Coke's there. So, yeah, you have enough to win. If not, you get it. Coke! Everybody, milk, 264, 261. Let's go, gentlemen. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something about a woman that might sparkle.
Her eyes.
What do you say?
Her eyes.
Her eyes. Player pass.
Richard, we're going to play.
Gentlemen, will not repeat it. 3 seconds to answer it. Name something about a woman that might sparkle. 3 seconds, Tom.
Her hair.
Hair. Yeah. 3 seconds, David.
Her jewelry.
Jewelry. Yeah. 3 seconds.
Her smile.
Her smile. If it's there, you keep your title. Smile. $64. We have nice prizes. I thank you for being here. I'm sorry you didn't do better.
You are, Richard. Thank you.
We were trying to use you on our night. They were on about 4 years ago and lost, so we hope you did. I thank you. And coffee was a great answer. Let's go, boys! Salt Lake City's going for the money right after we watch this.
Oh, oh, who's that kid with the Oreo cookie? Is this your one and only eating up the creamy middle, dunking all the luscious chocolate like he did when he was little? It's a chore to be mature when you're crunching an O-R-E-O. Oh, so yummy and appealing. The kid in you can't fight that feeling.
Oreo cookies for the kid in all of us.
Hi. I can. I'm barbecuing.
Barbecuing? It's winter.
I know it's winter, but if you put Hunt's all-natural barbecue sauce on chicken and bake it in the oven, it's just like barbecuing.
Oh, come on, Dave. How can I do that?
Because Hunt's is full of chunks of real vegetables. It's thick, and the thicker the better. See? The brush doesn't sink.
Brush? What brush?
Boy, I wish you could taste this. Mmm.
Dick.
Hunt's all-natural barbecue sauce. Try it in the oven.
Can I call you back? I'm a little tied up.
Are antiperspirants unfair to women?
Yeah. He gets speed stick, the wide stick, and I get a narrow one. Unfair, you bet. He gets solid protection and I get something delicate.
But now there's Lady Speed Stick, effective speed stick protection that glides on dry. And it's made specially for a woman, so it's gentle.
Lady Speed Stick antiperspirant protects you like a man,
but still treats you like a woman. That's fair. Lady Speed Stick.
By men.
What's Princess Di's maiden name?
Spencer.
Great! You know the best actor in 82?
Yes.
Get in it!
The answers in Parker Brothers' new People Weekly trivia game.
Who wrote the best-selling novel?
Questions are about today's most fascinating people in categories like TV, music, and sports. Thousands of questions in all.
Who's the tallest player in the NBA?
What do you think, kid?
Parker Brothers kind of fun!
Stick around, kid. You might learn something.
Brings people together.
Win the money, shall we?
Okay.
15 seconds, please. Tell me the hour of day when you need a snack the most.
2:30.
How many words per minute you can type?
40.
Something that might cost $1 million.
A house.
A city in Germany.
Munich.
A kind of meter.
A what?
A kind of meter.
I still don't understand the question.
Then say, excuse me.
Excuse me, I still don't understand the question.
You know, deafness in Utah is up 4 points since his family moved back home. A kind of meter.
Kind of
M-E-T-E-R.
Part parking meter.
Very good.
I was thinking M.
Shut up. If you listened instead of talk, they've got cantaloupes going in crepes. They got $18,000 of our money. Get a hearing phone.
What?
What? Tell me the hour of day you need a snack the most. You said 2:30. Survey said 2. How many words per minute can you type? You said 40 minutes. Survey said 18. Something that might cost $1 million. You said a house. Survey said. City in Germany, Munich, München. Survey. 19. Kind of meter, what? Meter, what? Meter, what? Parking, survey said. Here comes Tom.
Come on.
87 board, all we need. Please remind everyone the answers that John.
Pardon?
John. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Tell me the hour of day when you need a snack the most.
2:00.
How many words per minute can you type?
50.
Something that might cost $1 million.
Home.
Try again.
Farm.
All buildings. Try again.
Car.
A city in Germany.
Frankfurt.
A kind of meter.
Parking.
Try again. Turn around. Well, at least you heard it. The hour of day you need a snack the most. 3 p.m. was the number one. You said 2. Survey said 11. How many words per minute can you type? 60 words was number one. You said 50. Survey said 12. Something that might cost $1 million. I've got 2 of these. Gonna have to get rid of one. The ashtrays are filled. Survey said. Now. House property number one. But you're like a diamond.
Well, you know.
A diamond professor, you know, sir?
Oh, yeah. We never think about that. We're just happy to have half of a tip. So.
City in Germany. Is that Frankfurt? Get all my hot dogs from there. Berlin was number one. But Frankfurt. Survey said. 20. Kind of meter. Parking was number one. You said parking and ran out of time. $156, $5 every point. Total up. Thank you, $280. And we will return.
Yes, thank you.
I had to pay.
This is the pain-relieving medicine for which doctors have written 100 million prescriptions. And now you can get it in a new non-prescription strength. Bristol Myers introduces Nuprin. One tablet has the strength to relieve most minor aches and pains. Nuprin contains ibuprofen. It's a medicine totally different than aspirin or the ingredient in Tylenol. If you've had a serious problem taking aspirin, before taking Nuprin, ask your doctor. The medicine in new Nuprin, it's over 100 million prescriptions strong.
When you clean your toilet bowl, do you use one of these cleaners? You know, none of them disinfect. Not one. But here's one that does. Vanish. Powerful crystal or super thick liquid. They don't just clean, they disinfect. They give you the germ-killing power you want. See these concentrated bowl germs? Vanish kills them. Disinfects. Crystal and liquid vanish. The difference is disinfecting.
Wednesday, the fall guy meets Elvira, mistress of the dark.
The interesting question is for this young man is, how did you meet her? Love ya! See you here on the jury.
Some departing contestants receive Genie Jet Vac, the all-purpose wet-dry vacuum that handles any indoor or outdoor cleanup job fast. From dirty carpets to flooded basements, Genie Jet Vac. Ovaltine, fortified with 10 vitamins and minerals for better nutrition than any other leading milk flavoring, Ovaltine and chocolate and malt flavors. Lots of rich chocolate and 100% vegetable shortening make it easy to taste the sunshine difference in Chipperoo's chocolate chip cookies from Sunshine. Uncle Ben's original long grain and wild rice for an original way to enhance any meal.
Tonight, Blair becomes the target of a terrifying threat on Paper Dolls.
To meet Jennifer, an aspiring actress who's showing us her unhappy look. Jennifer's unhappy because she's wearing a saggy diaper that leaks. Well, here's Huggies, Jennifer. Huggies are form-fitting disposable diapers with soft, gentle elastic to help stop leaking. So Huggies hug to help keep babies dry and comfortable. Thick, absorbent Huggies diapers help keep babies dry.
So now you're showing us your happy look, right, Jennifer?
Here's a warning to people with nice, shiny acrylic bathtubs. You could scratch that shine off if you keep using a liquid cleanser. Watch as we clean this lens with liquid cleanser and the other with spick and span and water. Whatever happens to these acrylic lenses will eventually happen to your acrylic tub. So much for using liquid cleansers on acrylic. Spick and span, an all-shine, no-scratch cleaner.
Only the Tahitian Tanning and Fitness Centers give you elegance, quality equipment, expert instruction, and a chance to win wonderful prizes from Sunset Sports. Call today. Wheel of Fortune, weeknights on Channel 4.